Welcome back, my friends, to this Let's Play of Dominions 5, where we are playing the nation of Middle Ages, Abyssia. Let's continue from where we left off. Our nation is faring well. We are decimating Agartha over here, and in the rest of our borders, we have a nice foothold. So we are keeping a good pace of conquest and without getting my provinces well defended. Let me show you what I have decided for this turn, and after that we will finish the turn and see how the battles went. Right here in Agartha, they are almost vanquished from this map. I don't think they can recover from that. Probably they only will get Or the only province that they will keep, it's this one in the water, because it's going to be a little bit more difficult for me to conquer this one. But we'll see about that. Meanwhile, right here, we broke the castle walls, so we are going in the next turn to storm the castle. Next turn, the end of this one, and with a nice addition from our capital, our star player Etanim is going to join the battle. Our first Archdevil is straight from being summoned to his first battle. So I have equipped him with a couple of items. Normally these items are used in the thugs or super combatants. I am forging more items so that it can even be more stronger, because he clearly needs an helmet. He should wear a boots and an armor. But and even this misc slot that's empty, normally at least I use the amulet of anti-magic that gives a nice boost to magic resistance, because normally it's the way that these guys get killed. It's true magic, because by brute force it will be very difficult to destroy him. He has a lot of hit points, 62. He regenerates 10% of it each combat turn, and he has a vine shield that normally entangles the attacker, so the units that are around him get entangled and cannot attack. And I think that's it. So he's very difficult to kill by normal means. Magic, normally it's the way that he can be defeated. So if I can get this magic resistance a little boost, that should be useful. But for now, since he's going to join a nice army, let me just show you. This is the guys that are going to storm the castle. This guy is still doing an assassination. I think between turns, how the new turn is processed, assassinations occur before normal combat. So if this guy kills another enemy mage or captain, that mage or captain won't be available to defend the castle against our main army. So it's still useful to assassinate, even if I'm storming the castle in the same turn. And this is the army that's going to storm the castle, so I think that should be more than enough to get the castle to our nation. And our beautiful Etanim, our Archdevil, is going to do a fire shield. It's a self-protection spell. He's going to hold one turn and then attack rear. I will try to attack rear just at the same time as these normal units do. This hold and attack rear. Normally they hold for 2 turns and then attack rear. So I hope I counted that right. So he has 2 actions before doing also the attack rear, so that he can synchronize with these guys, and they all attack rear at the same time. At least that's the beautiful theory. Let's see in practice if I am correct. that all that info was against this castle over here in Cynthia, and I'm also trying to siege already Agartha. Two reasons. I really want to siege Agartha myself. I don't know if Pelagia is thinking the same thing or not. So I don't, and I really want their capital. It has very nice resources, very nice population, very good income. So I want this province. I would like not to start a war with Pelagia just because of this province, because they are all around in the water of my nation. And if I am at war with them, it will be a little bit troublesome to defend. We can defend effectively, but it will be troublesome because they can attack everywhere. So it's a little bit, we'll be shuffling all the turns, several armies. We have flying units. It won't be too bad, but I would like to avoid that. I will always want to be the aggressor, to be so that it is me that starts the war, not other nations. So that's the theory. It's a smallish army. It's just these guys. But probably all most of these units, they are researching and defending, not defending. They are researching and they are with captains that are researching. So we will only fight the province defense, and then we'll siege the castle, and there will be remaining units to fight. So these guys will siege the castle, and after we win this one, we all join to the party. At Agartha capital. So that's my thoughts for the next turns in Agartha are that ones. After all of this is mine, probably next it will be this throne that we won't get any trouble to conquer, even if it's a level 2 throne, because we have a nice set of armies over here. Next. Thinking a little bit ahead, as I have told you in the last episode, we are going to start the fight against Bandarlog. So I'm going to start moving units right over here. I still need to think a little bit about it, because it won't be too easy to reach Bandarlog. So I don't know if we are going to go over Vanaros. So kill Vanaros here. I think their main nation is over here, so we'll conquer all these provinces to ourselves and defend. So we will get several Vanaros provinces and get a nice foothold, a defensive foothold here, or I think it's here. I think there is a fort here, so we'll keep it. We'll fight them, just these three provinces, and then defend against them all of their attacks, because they only attack by land. And then attack all of Bandarlog, and let's see if we can have a couple of super combatants playing around with Vanaros. That's middle term, probably not in the next couple of episodes, but that's what I'm thinking about. For our domestic orders, our maintenance of our nation, let me just show you what I am doing. What I'm doing differently, because most of this is blood hunting, so you are all tired of seeing that all the episodes. My pretender is casting Summon Spectre. It's a conjuration level 6 spell that calls a death mage called Spectre. He can have several magic paths, so let's see what kind of mage we get. He's also a nice tank, so he can do double purpose. If he's a good mage, he can help forging items. If he has a nice combination of magic schools, he can be by himself with a couple of items, be a tank. Let me check also. We are resuming Lightless Lanterns. We have many now. We have more mages searching without Lightless Lanterns, so we are resuming it. We are getting 10 fire gems per month, so we'll be spending 5 of them in Lightless Lanterns to pushing even further our magic research. It's nice as it is, almost 700 research points, but let's push it even further so that you can reach the final levels of the magic schools. I don't want our Archdevil to feel too lonely, so we are getting another one. So he's going to get his brother or sister, I don't know, and to help our nation. Let me just check again. Any more information? No, that's it. Let's just check nation overview. Well, I will speak a little bit about a couple of more of magic items that I'm forging. I'm forging the Starshine Skullcap. It's an item that needs Astral 2 to be forged, and it gives a little bit of defense to the head of a unit, but it gives a plus one bonus to Astral Magic and a whooping, I think, plus five to magic resistance. So it's a very versatile item. It can be used to power up one of our Astral Mages to be even more powerful in Astral Magic, but it can also be given to thugs so that they have a very nice magic resistance. I'm building also Amulet of Anti-Magic. It just costs five Astral Gems. It can be forged by any Astral Mage because it only requires level one of Astral Magic. And it's just almost the same as the Starshine Skullcap, but it doesn't give the bonus to Astral Magic. The slots also matter a little bit. This one is to the MISC slot of a unit, and this one it's to the head slot. So we can even give both these items to the same unit, and it gives a very nice magic protection. Because, for instance, our Spectre is undead. So if he goes to a battle against many priests, all their divine spells do a lot of damage to undead units. So he almost always dies against many priests, but with this couple of items, he can resist the spells very easily. Only an unlucky roll can kill him with both that items equipped. And I think that's it. Too much talking, but I think it was needed, just this clarification of my thoughts. I think that's it. We have done all the we could do this turn. Recruitment, let me just show you. Capital, I'm not spending nothing in the capital. I want to keep a little surplus money because I'm building here a palisade, and I think I'm building something somewhere else. Let me just check. We already checked this screen, so if you have paused, probably you know what I've spent money. And I don't remember. Palisades, it's here. And I think that's it. I was just checking if I have built some kind of temple or something, but I know it's just over here, the palisades, and I selected my my castles nearer my borders so that I need to move less my troops to the recruitment. Here, salamander and human breeds. Right here, nothing. Here I have recruitment against salamander human breeds, and here. And here I two captains, assassin captain, and low resources, so I cannot recruit anything else. And here, nothing. And I spent all my money. I just got 420 gold coins left. Keeping the money, one of the options that I have to destroy this last province, it's to have such a high dominion around it that if their pretender lose all the candles, they die. So this province will become again an independent province. I'm keeping the money so that I can start building very quickly the temples, and I think that can solve our problem over here. I'm not sure, but even because we have very low dominion here, but I think that will be a solution to this province. I'm not sure. We are going to see it in the next turn. Let me just finish the turn because I'm tired to hear myself, and I need to finish the turn. These four commanders are scouts. that are very well where they are, so I don't want to move them. Let's check how we have done in our Agartha battles. This guy, yeah, lost a prophet, I set up a new one. Right, I like to see because sometimes this kind of message is they are deciding to attack us. So let me just check assassination. Our great prophet. This guy, ice elemental, because we are in a very cold province, so he gets a bonus. Even worse for this poor guy. Let's see. Yeah. No, horrible way to die. He died with an avalanche. Let me just check. Okay, a battle at Agartha. Probably will just fight province defense. Let me just check. Yeah, it's a province defense because last turn I have attacked, if you remember, with a scout and run away, and it's the same composition. So they have just many units because they have very invested much money in the province defense, but there are no extra units here. Probably this is just the only extra unit. And even if we have a couple of losses, that's fine because I really want to be me who seizes Agartha. And our devils, even if they die, they are easily replaced. And Agartha are rooted, so nothing to see here. Move along, move along. And we lost four devils. Yeah, these three were the only ones that weren't province defense. The rest were province defense. And let me check the fortress of Cynthia. Yeah, we won't have any trouble against this small army, even with my well. Unfortunately, our Archdevil did not join the fight. Why did he not? Perhaps if when we storm the castle, only the armies that are already in the province are the ones that can do it, not the ones that move to the province in the same turn. I would really like to see our Archdevil in action. We'll see him in our next battle. Let's just and just the guys in the walls. They take a little bit longer to destroy. Because it's easy, it is very difficult to get to them at the walls. Let me just check. We lost two devils and seven human breeds. These guys trampled, so they trampled a couple of human breeds. Nothing too much. And we got the fortress. Let me just check. Unexpected events, less population. It's okay. A little bit of more of gold and more unrest. No. We lost a shadow imp, but he died, but he took with him a wolf. And we start destroying Agartha and we are doing damage. Nice, very nice. Patrol info down here. And let's just check. We got a specter, another Archdevil, a magic sight, nice. And blooding all over the place. Yeah, good turn. Check, let me just check what did my camel, the sorceress, found. She found probably this which, yeah, which is block plus one water plus one depth. I can always use that gem, so that's nice. Let me check the specter, two death and one water. That's nice because if I want more specters, I will give him this cool staff that gives death magic plus bonus to our specter, and he can himself call more specters. And I don't need my. Where the hell is the specter? Okay. I don't need my pretender. I'm going to do that just now. Search. As much as I can, I want my pretender to site search. And summon another specter. We'll get a couple, this and one more. If I get one with the Astral, it's a nice one to make him attack. This guy, so-so. Let me just, what? Messages again. How could I forgot? Let me get the devil. We got Igarak. Again, I don't know if the stats are all the same. I think they can. Yeah, they have small variations. This guy can also fly. Four, like the other one. I think that they are almost the same. This kind of stats over here. And he has an Infernal Strength. And Banish to Inferno. The initiative that he hits. I don't know what really is that, but probably outright kills it. No, I don't know. And the Barbatel. The other guy had a Firebrand. And that's it. We are calling all the brothers. We are going to have nice family dinner with all the six Archdevils. I could even join them. I don't know with their cousins, the Ice Devils. I don't know if they get along nicely, but that would be a nice family dinner. Well, for now, let's just quickly check the borders to see if anything new. Probably not. Very many sea serpents over here, but they are water units, so they cannot attack in the land. And I think that's it. Right here, this is all the sites, magical sites that I got to have. We here have already laboratory. One air, one death, and one earth. That's nice. That's nice. We'll get a lot of gems to use. Down here, no news. Right here, no news. We lost here. Ape. That's it, my friends. I'm going to think about this turn, and I'll be right back. Well, I have given all the movements for my turn. Let me just move this guy that I forgot to move. He probably can move down here. In this turn, my friends, I'm trying to start moving the armies over here to our southwest border so that we can storm and attack without noticed Vanaros, so that they have little time to defend themselves. So if you can see here, it's easier here. I'm moving. This is the guy that is already here. He's trying to get a lot of more of crossbows. And sorry, again, these ones. This guy is coming from the capital with 35 devils. And he's joined with my lovely second Archdevil, Igarak. So we are going to set up in this province as a foothold to attack all of these provinces. Because since we are a heat nation, all of these rivers we cannot cross normally. So they are only available to cross in just a couple of turns per year, even so. So the only reliable way to attack is through here and through here. So we are going to quickly do all the our attacks in the near turns against Vanaros, and we are setting up to do so. Let me just show you the rest. Right here, we conquered this castle. We are going to move all our flying units directly to, I think it's just one, directly to the castle. And let me just show you, and that's it. So these guys are in the castle. They are joined by this one to help the siege, and our lovely first Archdevil this time he'll arrive to the fight in time, so he will kill a lot of Agartha units in after we destroy the walls. Let me just show you. Yeah, our assassin is going to. So our prophet assassin is going to try to kill a couple of units before we break the siege. The rest of the info. And now I am forging a couple of items. I'll show you right in a moment. My pretender is site searching. Our specter, new specter, is starting. Is calling another specter, and here we are going to get another archdevil. And I think the rest is just the same recruitment. I'm salamanders over here, and human breeds and crossbows. This province doesn't have a lot of resources, so we cannot recruit there too many units. And I'm saving money because I'm going to fill this up with temples. So probably in the next couple of turns, I won't do anything else than build temples. I'm already moving a couple of priests to do so over there, so that we can transform this province to an independent one. And let me just check with you quickly nation overview. No big information. I'm getting Armor of Knights. Summon Spectre I already talked about. Lightless Lantern I talked about last turn. I'm doing that monthly now. Again, another Ring of Regeneration to one of our Archdevils. And Blood Hunts, a couple of scouts that are hiding because they are used to blood hunt to ferry blood slaves, so they are waiting for to go somewhere to get the blood slaves. And let me just check here. I want you to patrol. Have I already told you how much I like this screen? It's a paramount of importance to check if you forgot any kind of order, because you just find the defend, and normally defend means that I forgot to give an order. It's even more important like this because we have already many units, so in this screen it's normal that we forget a province and we don't do all the orders. But by pressing F1 and getting to this screen, it's a nice way to check your overview of your nation very easily. So I think I didn't forget anything, or at least by looking at the screen I haven't. Let's just check the magic. No, this is the messages. Magic, we are level encampment level 6. We're level 5. We will reach level 6 next turn. That's nice. And I think that's it. Let's finish the turn. Let's see. This turn I don't think we have any battles. No, I don't, unless I get attacked like this. We got attacked in Pungria. Let me just check. Okay, I don't know what kind of attack was that, but they lost. We got attacked in the Garda. Are you joking? Why did Pelagia do that? I'm baffled. Why are they attacking? So strange. Cannot the AI see that I'm sieging a castle? That's so strange. I didn't understand this kind of move. Are they now attacking me? Because if they are, that changes the plans a little bit. We have here a battle between Pangea and Vanaros. Pangea won. Wow, what? Are you joking? This is a huge army. What the hell? I imagine, let me just the battle. I'm going to just what the F word? That is a fucking huge army. I don't know, because in this kind of army, our devils will get a really tough time because they cannot reach them, all their commanders, so that we can rout the army. What the hell? What? Man, that is a big ass huge army. Okay, I'm looking forward to this kind of challenge. Let's see if this army stands so that we can think a way to destroy all of these guys. But okay, it was just a. And we had here a battle between Pangaea. Yeah. The same province were attacked by several units, and Pangaea with 11 guys tried to attack an army with almost 500. I don't need to tell you how that went. But it's okay. And I think that's it. Let me. Expected event. A plague. No big deal. And here, plus 10 defense. Okay. We lost a scout. And we still haven't destroyed all the walls at Agartha. That's okay. Let's just check. Now we got Buriol with the trident. Yeah, the stats are, I think, are all the same. Small variation in the weapon that they have. Let's just check the borders a little bit quick. I don't know, and I can I and it was like we got started with war against Atlantis with a single attack by one unit, a strange attack, and after that they attacked us. So I don't know if I can expect an attack from Pangaea somewhere in our nation, but I'm going to think about it. No news here. This is okay, they are going to use this army probably to take out the sieging army here or here. So that won't be pretty. I'm going to leave that scout here. I don't know if I have a scout to move here. Okay, but I'm already starting to give orders, and I don't want to do that. I just want to check with you all of all of our borders, see if there are any differences, and we can also check. And yes, we got a nice second Spectre. No astral, but that not it's not a big deal because I don't really need to use them as tugs since I have the Archdevils. They are much better suited to do so. But I wanted that death over the sorry that Earth pass over there so that I can forge items without right using my dragons. This guy chest wound. Okay, for him it's no trouble because he won't be fighting melee. My friends, that's it. In this episode, I only covered 2 turns. Too much waffle in the first one. Too much talking, and but it's kind of usual when we reach this kind of stage of the game because there are a lot of info to process and lot of to talk about. Please let me know in the comments what are your thoughts about that. If you want me to be a little bit more quick or a little bit more slow. I'm trying to keep one episode a day, so even if I just do 2 turns today, you will get another episode tomorrow. So it is the same. It's just easier to me to manage my time because for each turn I lose about or I use about 15 minutes recording it. But between turns, probably about 30 minutes, giving all the orders and checking all the armies and seeing all the moves. And as our nation gets bigger, that gets a little bit. I need a little bit more time to do that. So now this episode gets 2 turns, and we are going to see the next ones if it's quicker or slower. But more slower than 2 episodes per episode, I don't think so. So my friends, I hope you have liked it. I hope if you are liking it, please like the video, please subscribe. That will be really appreciated. It gives me a notion of what you got, what you guys like to see. So I hope to see you in the next episode. We'll have a really nice party of Archdevils, and we are going to have dinner with Vanaros and Bandarlog. So I hope to see you in the next episode, and until then, thank you.